Hey guys, I'm Miss Haridas and this is the Study Hive. Here we go, we're going to be learning about biodiversity. So I'm going to take you to my lesson. It took me ages to put together, by the way, but I will be faster once I learn the ways. Right, so if we look at biodiversity, the main kind of objective is you want to understand what is biodiversity, and there are specific key words that you want to pay attention to. So things like, what does it mean by a habitat? What does it mean when I say species, ecosystems? What does species evenness versus species richness actually really mean? So if I take you down through this PowerPoint, I'm going to break down what biodiversity is. So really, if I split the word up, bio, like biological, anything that is natural, and diversity is looking at differences. So if we just put that here, so biological, and then if I take the word diversity, differences. So by definition, it's just a measure of the variety that you have in life. Now, with biodiversity, it's really hard to just look at something and say, I think this is way more biodiverse than this area over here. So we have to actually categorize or split biodiversity into three different sections. So we can split biodiversity by species, so species biodiversity. We can split it by genetics biodiversity, or we can split it by habitat biodiversity. So let's look into each one of these categories. So habitat biodiversity is where organisms live effectively. So what is a habitat? Is it can be defined by an ocean. Oh, my brother's laughing at me. An ocean, a sand dune, a woodland, a rainforest, etc. So it's where these different organisms actually live. So we can look at an ecosystem and see how many different habitats are there to assess how biodiverse it is. Another thing we can look at is species biodiversity. So before we go into what species biodiversity is, what does it mean when I say a species? Now, a species, when you look at a species, generally they look very similar. You've got similar anatomy. The physiology might be the same. The genetics and the biochemistry are all very, very similar. But how do we really define what a species is? They must be able to produce fertile offspring. So species diversity, when you're looking at, you know, how biodiverse an area is based on how many different species there are, let's look at my little cute animation of different species to show you that there can be different species to assess that. But the issue with species biodiversity is, if I was to look show you these two diagrams, so you've got a wildflower meadow and you've got a garden lawn. Now, the problem is both of them, let's get my pen out here for you, both of them actually have 25 different species. But they do not look the same in terms of being biodiverse. So we can't just measure biodiversity based on the number of different species that exist on the wildflower meadow versus the garden lawn. So we look at these two terms over here, which is species richness and species evenness. Now, species richness is the number of plant species that exist. So like I said over here, both had 25 organisms, but species evenness is the degree at which the species are actually represented. So you can see in the wildflower meadow, they have 25 species, just like the garden lawn, but they are so much more evenly distributed in that area, whereas with the garden lawn, you can see that the grass blade species generally dominates over the other species. There's 90% more grass species than there are of the little plant species that I've drawn on. So therefore, based on those two factors, we can actually say that the wildflower meadow is a lot more biodiverse. The third thing we can look at is genetic diversity. So genetic diversity, you can see here, is a number. I've got a number of different dogs here of the same species, but they all have slightly different characteristics, and those characteristics come from the different genes that they have. So in the same way, I've got a little picture, insight into my family here. So this over here is not a boy, that's actually me, and this is my little baby brother, and here again we've grown up, so that's me again, and my younger brother who's now taller than me. But we show an example of genetic diversity. We don't look exactly the same. We are part of the same species, but we have different genes, and that's another way to measure biodiversity. So to summarise the introduction of biodiversity, it's the measure of all the different plants, the animals, the fungi, microorganisms, species that exist worldwide. Not just that though, also the genes that they contain and the ecosystems of which they form a part of. So that can be categorised into habitat, species or genetic biodiversity. And when we're looking at that specifically, we're looking at species richness, which is the number of the organisms, and species evenness is how well they're distributed, and those factors allow us to really see how biodiverse an area is. I hope that made sense. I hope that made sense. And I will see you soon.